The ruling against Monsanto last week was the latest in another black eye for agriculture. If you believe that it was just Monsanto's problem, though, you're mistaken. Yes, there are certainly a segment of our population that like to believe that Monsanto is the spawn of Satan, and their agenda in life is to pollute the earth with their genetically modified seeds and chemicals, and wipe life as we know it from this planet in favor of their agenda. Of course, as the American public, as a Midwest consumer, or even as a just person living in the heart of agriculture, you know that's not true. Monsanto has single-handedly, with their genetics, eliminated millions of pounds of chemicals that go into our environment and done a lot of good for our environment. But at the same point, the fact remains that we have a public relations problem when it comes to how consumers view American agriculture. I'm Keith Byerly, Precision Ag Manager at Central Valley Ag, and this is your agronomy-focused video that corresponds with my article on the CVA website. If I ask a farmer what they do, I usually get some variation to the statement, "I feed the world." In capitalism, there's possibly not a more noble mission statement that exists than that particular statement right there. We as the American farmer provide not just the USA, but the entire world with one of the safest, most abundant, and cheapest food supplies that can be grown on this planet. But yet at the end of the day, we don't have the trust of the American consumer in many cases anymore, and we don't know why. We certainly can't look back in history and pinpoint a certain event or even a certain time frame that really led us to this place. It's something that's happened over time. Regardless of what our perceptions are, we know that the reality is that we need to work harder to gain the American public's trust. Now, we know that we really have two problems out there. The first problem is the science. If the science was definite and the science would change people's minds by itself, we would have never had this ruling last week about glyphosate being the problem and being the carcinogen that got this ruling against Monsanto. The science doesn't support it. It's emotion that had a jury award that settlement in that case. It's emotion that gets us bent out of shape when we hear about toxins that are in our cereal, even if the science says they're well below a dose that's even remotely dangerous for someone young or old. So, what we have to focus on as the American farmer is our opportunities to engage the problem. We need to be more purposeful every day in challenging what has become the status quo out there, especially as we move away from the Midwest and out towards the coast. For those of you that are online, you have to engage on Twitter, on Instagram, on all those social media points every day, and you have to encourage your spouse to do the same. We certainly need to encourage and implore our commodity groups, our checkoff groups, our financial institutions, our ag retailers, and everybody else that's involved in agriculture to be more engaged in this discussion, and what I'll even go as far as to say is a fight. But that's not enough. It's everybody's job to be involved in this. So that's my call to action for you today. This is a job that is everyone's responsibility. And if some of us think that it's not our responsibility, it'll fall by the wayside and nobody will do it. We all have to be engaged for the greater good. We all have to take the responsibility on our shoulder, and we all need to engage people, especially the consumers that don't trust American agriculture, where they're at, and show them the safety, show them the stories, and connect emotionally and scientifically with them to begin to try to turn this tide to regain the trust of our consumers.